Smashing things was fun. Felt like he was ready to learn new things. Thank goodness he didn't have to go to school for that. Imagine getting a horse up in one of these things. He would be cursing a blue streak. Original. Renato wondered if his future self had commissioned these poles. Meant by a firewall. What unlocks a firewall? All he needed now was a workbench, and he could slot it into his gauntlet.
See? It was actually very fine weather, except for the occasional shower of ravens. And no one was burning the ruins down with the mighty power of a god's eye. If the Empire believed anything he'd said, they certainly weren't showing it.
You blinked.
Most people still use doorknobs.
It's a very cool sword, thought Renara. No, seriously. He couldn't feel his paw anymore.
As he told his hilarious adventures to the Rebel Council, he began to realize they weren't laughing, just staring at him with those big bug eyes.
Zenobia, let you escape?
Asked the speaker.
How do we know you're not a double agent?
Then I wouldn't tell you about her at all.
Maybe you're trying to sound like an idiot, so we don't realize how clever you are,
croaked the speaker.
No, I promise you, I really am that much of an idiot,
Renata was about to say when a half dozen Imperial ships began to bomb the base.
He's betrayed us,
croaked the toads, and Renata decided it would be good to be somewhere else.
He boarded the Farfarer and got out of there.
The wind ruffled Renata's fur the wrong way.
So the Rebels thought he was lying too? Because a half dozen lousy dropships had probably just tripped over the Rebel base?
Okay, technically, he had betrayed its location, but not willingly. And he'd made up for it, hadn't he? Then something exploded. A cannon shot. The Farfarer plunged out of the clouds. The rebels had hit his ship.
As the Farfarer plummeted towards the abyss, he launched himself into the sails of an Imperial ship.